Agriculture is the backbone of any country, and for Kiambu County, which is known for its rich soils and bumper harvests since time immemorial, residents were almost giving up and longed for a day when change would come and agriculture would be given priority. With the swearing-in of Governor James Nyoro, who's an agricultural economist, things changed for the better.
Our main mandate issues to do with the food security. As you all know, that agriculture is a fully devolved function, and you are in charge of all the crop husbandry, animal husbandry, all the abattoirs that promote the issue of food security and economic sustainability.
We have talked about food insecurity and we have talked about agriculture as one of the areas where we as the county government will be concentrating on in ensuring that we economically empower our farmers.
The Department of Agriculture, Livestock and Irrigation's main objective is to ensure a healthy, food secure and prosperous country by promoting sustainable agriculture through capacity building on agricultural productivity, food nutrition and security, value addition, marketing extension and infrastructure development. Immediately the new administration took office, action around food security and mitigation against the economic effects of COVID-19 global pandemic intensified with the distribution of maize and bean seeds, food crop fertilizer and coffee fertilizer across all the 12 sub-counties in Kiambu County. The different variety of seeds distributed are suitable for different agroecological zones to ensure high yield for the farmers.
We want to promote the issue of now the food and nutritional security in line with the Big Four agenda of the national government. And also within the county government, we are talking about economic empowerment and post-COVID recovery. Today, we are launching the seed and fertilizer distribution program today so that the farmers will have the seeds within their farms starting from Monday.
We've been going through some trials and the farmers have been doing the trials themselves. And that is why we have been giving those very small packs, the 25-gram pack of all the varieties. And it is farmers who have decided which variety is appropriate to their area. So when you see the distribution that we are going to make today, you realize that the maize variety that is going to go to Goriba and Gatuanyaga is completely different from the maize variety that is going to be in Kiambu, Githunguri, Gatundu South and Gatundu North.
Tene tutire twakorwo tukiheo bebe. No ria gavana itwokire. Riu nituigwa tukenete oni turagirwo bebe o hindi ya kuhanda kuhanda. Tutire twaga bebe. Riu tari mungira bebe ici ciothe igu kuni cia kuheo ti hatire kugura. Na murakiona bebe ici uri akiri thaka. Riu nai turigwa tukenete tene andu ni riu guku gu kwaca itura riri ritu ria mitero. Nitunirirwo ngaragu ni gavana witu. Toru tene ni turathi na nginya ni irio ni turathi na nginya ni turathi angere gitukagura irio cia kuria no ni undu wa kuheo mbegu iracia mbegu ire iracia ra mbegu njega rugu kugwito thina rege tuge ni uthirite ugo twacokia ngatho muno na tukera ngai aige Mr. James Nyoro as our governor
areke njuge ni turakena muno ni tondu ori ra turarutirwo mwega na turona utigani hau kabere in fact ni wega kuga turaiguaga maundu ta mana kuria Murang'a kwa mwangi wa iria uri arimi makenaga ni uri maroretwo wega makaheo bebe makaheo fertilizer. We go to it is the reality. Today, head to a baby, to carry a fertilizer, to casoka, to carry a training, to carry training. We are going to call you to work. So, we are going to do it. Nani gweda gushokia gado ni gemo na muna kule the government ya Kiambu aitongoretio yone governor wetu Dr. James Nyoro.
Mwaka jana tulisaidiwa na governor wetu na pamoja na Kiambu County akatusaidia na fertilizer ile tulipatia wakulima wetu. Tulipata fertilizer ya Fanisi na Yala na Mijingu ambayo tulipatia wakulima wetu na waka apply hiyo fertilizer mwezi wa 9-10 hapo. Kwa hivi sasa tunaona hiyo fertilizer imetusaidia sana kwa vile tumeona tumetembea mashamba ya wakulima wetu na tunaona flowering ile iko na pinheads zile ziko ime improve sana. Tunaona production itakuwa labda mara mbili ama tatu hivi kulingana na vile tulikuwa hapo zamani.
Hiyo fertilizer tulipewa ni Kiambu au tulipatiwa ni Kiambu County. Gavana wetu alifanya kazi nzuri sana. Iko na tofauti kubwa sana. Sana. Unaona hii tunaweka mwezi ya 10. Naona kahawa yetu inakuwa mzuri. Muendelee na muende bere kutuletea hiyo fertilizer. Na niyo kitu mzuri sana.
The impact of these interventions is clear among farmers and stakeholders alike through Kiambu County. To bring synergy, the county has brought in partners to work with in order to ensure agricultural productivity and profitability among all age groups. The county had been working together with the national government, the World Bank, Food and Agriculture Organization, the State Department of Fisheries, among others, to support farmers across the county. The impact of these partnerships on the ground is enormous, with the hope of changing the lives of the beneficiaries and ensuring that their lives change for the better.
The project in Kiambu County is in 5 sub-counties of Rari, Rimuru, Kikuyu, Gatundu North and Gatundu South. We are implementing value chains, that is dairy, Irish potato, banana and chicken.
Wakati tuliposikia kutoka kwa ofisi za Ministry of Agriculture kwamba kuna mradi unaitwa NARIG ambao unakuja kusaidia wakulima ambao wanafuga ng'ombe na ambao wanafuga banana, na pale tukaweza kujisajilisha, tukaweza kurekodisha kikundi chetu pale na tukaweza kuandika proposal. Ile proposal ikakaguliwa na ikaweza kudhibitishwa, tukakuwa funded na tukaweza kuletewa hizi machines ambazo tunasiaga chakula nayo, tukaletewa crusher, tukaletewa mixer, tukaletewa ratili ya kupima ile mizani na ile mashini ya kushona zile gunia. Na kutoka pale tumekuwa tukifundishwa jinsi ya kutengeneza chakula bora na ambayo itaweza kuongezea mapato na faida zaidi kwa mkulima.
In County Community Land Development, we have a number of projects that have been approved. We have Kamwamba Irrigation Project. We also have Rimuru ESL, that is the extended shelf life to support the dairy value chain. And we have 6 sustainable land management projects that are being implemented. And in the 6 SLMs, we are doing 20 water pods per SLM. So in total, we have 120, out of which Kamwamba SLM is complete with 20 water pods. They also have the pods have been lined. They have solar pumps, and the farmers are using the water for irrigation to support various and high value horticultural crops.
Hapo mwanzo kama mgelijua hii shamba ilikuwa barren. Yaani palikuwa maji ilikuwa inatoka barabarani, alafu yanafagia kila kitu. Lakini kwa saa hizi juu ya hizi terraces kuna ardies na terraces, na pia nimepanda hizi manapis. So zimefanya kuzuia yale ule unyonyoko wa udongo. Kwa hivyo sasa baadaye kuchanganya na hii maji ninapoitumia, nimeweza kulima vitu kama nyanya, kuna vitu kama pilipili hoho, pia kuna kabeji, na hata kuna vitu zingine nyingi, hata spinach, managu, na hata gojet type, na hata madizi pia nakuza.
In an attempt to improve food security and nutritional security of our people, the project wants to utilize all the small water bodies in the county. And we have been able to stock an initial 3 dams. We are working with Trigger Dam, Tigoni Dam and Rungere Dam, and each has been stocked with 22,000 fingerlings. We have also been able to work with communities around the dams so that they can conserve the dams and be able to utilize this resource for their own food security and even for income.
We received 22,000 fingerlings from the county in December. And what we can say, siusaidika sana kama youth, because that is one way of finding a means of living, juu tutaweza kutega fish na tutapata food hapo. Na tena tutaweza kujikeep busy na activities mingi sana za maji as we fish.
Tulishikanishwa na county government ya Kiambu na FAO. Hao ndo walitushikanisha, wakatuleta pamoja, alafu tukaanza training ya kupanda herbs and spices na bado vegetables. Vile tumeangalia juu, tumefunzwa maka juu ya gross margin analysis. Kulingana na hizo gross margin, profits zimekuwa ziko sawa.
In this project we have 6 variations. One is a local poultry, where we are actually specifically dealing with local chicken. We have the piggery, we have the herbs and spices and the local vegetables. In all these variations, FAO, or Food Agriculture and Organization, have involved in capacity building for the youth and also giving out the input for the youth.
The beneficiary wa mradi wa FAO ilatua hiruwa wade through Kiambu County wa hiruwa horo wa kureithia kwa guku. Mudanya wa bere, tuwabe tugeza umidhi horo wa kure la guku. Tuke horo hygiene, vaccine, na horo wa woshirela wa yagana woshiakira structures. Tuma hau, tushoka tukere hiruwa tushu itua day old chick 50, na tukabere ilia utore la wega. So far, nituoneta umidhi wa atuo. Now, men are 4 months old. To enter us, we get to have a go again for through Kiambu County. To have a go 500, so that you could be. Na kuma hao nito theater.
Dairy farming has not been left out, with a dairy cattle population of 250,000 herds distributed in all the 12 sub-counties. The free artificial insemination program will make it a reality for farmers to achieve one calf per ear per cow.
We have the key sector being dairy, and Kiambu is one of the leading counties in terms of dairy production. Being the leading, we are also promoting that in terms of now the primary production. We are providing AI in two areas. One is conventional semen, which is free to all the farmers, but we have upgraded that to sex semen, which is much speedier, but we are sharing the cost between the farmers or the cooperatives on a 50% shareholding.
Ng'ombe si yakwa heagirwo mbegu ni andu akauti toro andu acio ni mahereire mbegu he mundu ngimaherire na harugo ng'ombe yake na wegiciara andu magikimaka na toro andu amera gwati matuwe maoni fake ndira yakwa yendire ni odetire na magiuka na makihera na thutha kuhera ng'ombe yakwa ni raciarira mahatha morigire hamwe hamwe kwanza na ndirakena ni undu woguo na ng'ombe yo ndina ngiona hanini.
I've been a beneficiary of the genetics from Kagri that have been provided free of charge by the county government of Kiambu since last year. The services from the county government are free of charge. And as a dairy farmer, we want to get and save each and every single dime that we can. And you know, good semen is also very, very expensive. And that is a major cost for a dairy farmer. So when you're given semen that is of high quality, like the one that we are getting from the county government, that is a very important step in improving your profits at the end of the day. I have inseminated a lot of cows. So far, I have inseminated over 20 of my cows with that semen, and I have already had two calves, two heifers.
With food, nutritional and economic security, Governor Nyoro's administration has ensured the residents of Kiambu can afford a smile and have their farms tell the transformational story all the way. Governor,